Hello, my name is George Milios. I reside in central Massachusetts. I'm a 57-year-old male, and I've been diagnosed with intrahepatic stage 4 cholangiocarcinoma. My diagnosis was done back in October of 2019. Before that time, I had a prostate surgery, and a year went by. I had no issues, no symptoms whatsoever. And then we discovered a small cyst at one of the incision points of the surgical area of the robotic surgery. At that point, I immediately called my prostate doctor. We did a CAT scan with him. And within a day, we knew that it was cholangiocarcinoma stage 4. We immediately met with the chief oncologist at our local hospital, who wanted me to go for a second opinion, just so I realized that he was exactly accurate, and his prognosis was that we would be able to contain the tumors and the cancer, but not defeat it. At that point, I did get the second opinion, and I felt very good that the chemotherapy that we did was the right course of action for that time. But again, I really experienced no symptoms, but a simple cyst in one of the incision points. And it just startled me enough to confirm what it was exactly. So at that point, we have maintained now for about 16 months through the chemotherapy that we had taken care of or had done at that point. And now we are here 2 years later, and we're still pretty much fighting strong. And we had gotten a biomarker test at the major hospital here in the area. And that is exactly what a cholangiocarcinoma or any cancer patient would need, because that will give you the key to unlocking what mutations you have bad in your body. Again, it's a simple blood test. They did draw approximately 4 vials of blood. And at that point, I knew what the bad mutations were in my body and what we knew should the initial chemotherapy stop working, and we would be lucky enough to find something that may target the mutations. Otherwise, we would be doing a clinical trial and or finding another type of chemotherapy that may work or respond to my body. I'm happy to say at this point, I have been fighting strong once again, and we're happy to be here, and we're blessed with some of the wonderful technology in the world, especially in the northeast corner of the United States. And I'm sure the main thing would be finding a doctor and a care team that you'd be very comfortable with. And hopefully, again, the biomarker is imperative, the biomarker testing, and that would lead you to where you may need to be, and hopefully have a decent outcome or satisfactory outcome. On that note, I'm currently contained as far as the tumors, and right now we're keeping the spread of the cancer at bay. And with that being the case, we're actually in a good situation beyond total any type of remission. We're exactly where we need to be with the technology available. So the main points would be absolutely get your diagnosis as soon as possible. They did a turnaround for me. I saw the chief oncologist within 2 days of the CAT scan. He explained to me everything that cholangiocarcinoma entailed, how difficult the disease it is, gave no timelines as to how long we would survive. The survival rate can be difficult. I wouldn't recommend really believing it. And also any therapies that they prescribe, certainly feel free to get a second opinion. It really gives you the peace of mind to feel that you're in the right hands. And there are many resources available for us cancer patients. And we just have to keep fighting and keep praying and just hope for the best and seriously believe in the technology that's out there. A lot of research goes into this. And these folks do a diligent and professional job. My experience has been nothing but wonderful, considering everything that we're up against. It's the only thing that consumes me as far as fighting for my wife and son. And I have to keep a positive attitude. They have built a great support system around me between friends and family, and everything's is as positive as possible. Down days are tough, but you look past them and you have to realize you're glad to be alive, and you take it a day at a time. It's an old adage, but it is the true adage. You have to just believe in yourself, believe in your strength, which, by the way, the strength, both physical and mental, you have no idea how your body makeup is, physical and mental, of course, until you're faced with this situation. It's hands down the toughest thing you have to fight to live. And my best advice to anyone would be, and it's an old adage again, but it's truly what it is. Never give up, never give hope, never give up on hope, never stop hoping. And truly, until you start seeing some results, hope is a very difficult thing to realize and believe, but it's there. And I just want to say, I thank my lucky stars every day. I wake up, I enjoy my wife and son as best as possible. I have very few side effects now, if any. The chemo, of course, is very difficult, but once you get beyond those things, you're okay. So you just have to keep the faith and fight strong.